I'm very pleased to be joined now by the former governor of Maryland, former mayor of Baltimore as well, Martin O'Malley. Thank you very much for coming on the show. We appreciate it. I know you knew Congressman very, very well. Your thoughts on his passing?
Yeah, so many memories. I mean, I feel like I've known Elijah Cummings all my life, and the gift of this man's service to all of us is that lots of people can say that, whether they'd ever met him or not. He had this, he was a very much a person who, you know, was of the people. I first got to meet him when I was a young lawyer in the district courts of Baltimore City, and Elijah would be there as well with clients, real people, real cases, waiting his turn on the bench, and whether it was Wabash Avenue or other courts. So I don't know. I have a lot of memories going through my head right now.
Governor, it's Ann Kramer. I wanted to know, what kind of politician would you say Elijah Cummings was, and what kept him going in the political realm and that he was so successful in getting reelected so many times?
Many of us became so familiar with his constant refrain that our children are the messages we send to a future that we will never see. And that was not a throwaway line for Elijah Cummings. It was a truth that he deeply believed. So what animated his work every day, I truly believe, was this notion of generational progress, that each of us has the ability as Americans to do better by our kids, to give them a better life. And by giving them a better life, make our country and our world better places. Now, that's what animated this guy. He was fierce as a fighter. I mean, many people in the nation saw him as he was steadfast and courageous and fearless and discharging his oversight duties of our current president and this administration. I knew him as governor, as a guy that actually sweated the details and worked hard to get us to what would have been much better mass transit options for people in his beloved West Baltimore and East Baltimore and throughout our city with the red line. And I also knew him as somebody who was always willing to throw himself into that kind of mosh pit of democracy, whether it was in the House of Delegates or whether it was in Congress. I mean, Elijah Cummings played the long game. He worked hard every single day for the people that he loved, and he understood that our government matters, and it matters in the lives of real people in very real ways every single day. I think that there were a few things that he was quite as proud of as extending, the work that we were able to do to extend health care coverage to hundreds of thousands of people who did not have it before under Maryland's old Medicaid system. And then, of course, with President Obama's election, it was my great honor to be with him introducing the president when he stopped in Baltimore on his way to Washington, D.C. So I don't know what to tell you, Ann. I mean, this is a man I worked with my whole life that I had the ability to serve in politics. We even shared a birthday and, been to so many events of one another. I remember very distinctly his first congressional election, but even before that in 1986, I remember him being one delegate in the Mitchell team over on the West Side when I was working for Barbara Mikulski. So I feel like I grew up with Elijah Cummings, and this is a real shock, and it's a great loss for all of us.
Governor, this is John Patty. What would you say his legacy is going to be to the state of Maryland, to the city of Baltimore, and to the United States?
You know, I think if there's a legacy, I believe that legacy, the legacy of Elijah Cummings, is a legacy of caring for and never forgetting about his neighbors and the truth that we're all in this together, and that we need each other and have to help each other if we're going to succeed. Even though he was in the halls of Washington, he always came home to Baltimore, and his life and his passion was lifting people up and doing everything he could to help people be the best they could be.
Governor, good to have you on. We really appreciate you coming on the show. Thanks so much.
Thank you, Governor.
Thank you all.